Hi, this is Sharon Machlis, Director of Editorial Data and Analytics at IDG Communications. In this first episode of Do More with R, we're going to look at how easy it is to create an interactive scatter plot with multiple trendline choices. I'll be using the taucharts package, and for data, the MTCars dataset familiar to almost all R users. It has a few data points for some automobile models. I'll tell you how to install taucharts in a bit, since it's not on CRAN yet, including a cool package for installing from GitHub that you might not know about. But first, let me show you what taucharts does, so you'll want to install it. I load taucharts, MTCars, and dplyr. Why dplyr? Because I always end up wanting to use dplyr when I'm working in R. Run that. Next, I'll tweak MTCars to give it the format I want. I'll be creating a scatter plot showing miles per gallon by car weight, so I'll just keep the MP, G, and WT columns. I also want to add a column for the car model names. The default MTCars data frame has model names as row names, but not their own column. Here's the code for all of that. You can see I'm selecting two columns from MTCars in the first line, then adding a model column with mutate. Okay, run that, and we're ready to graph. Tauchart sets my data source. The next line of code says, I want a scatter plot, or graph with points, with weight on the x-axis and MPG on the y-axis. If you're familiar with ggplot2, note a difference here. You need the column names inside quotation marks with taucharts. Next, I want to add a tooltip, and I want to add trendline options. If we run this code, and then open that up in a browser window, voila, here's an interactive scatter plot. You can mouse over points to see the data behind them. The tooltip command added all the columns in the graph's dataset to the tooltip. That's why I wanted models to be in a column. TauTrendline shows a linear trend line by default, but you can see that there are other options. That's how easy it is to create an interactive scatter plot with multiple trendline options in R. As promised, now here's information about installing taucharts. The package was written by security data scientist Bob Rudis. It's on his GitHub at his Harbormaster account. You can install it with the DevTools package, but another compelling option, if you're lazy and don't want to have to type out the author's GitHub account name, is the GitHub install package. You can install that the usual way with install.packages, GitHub install, all one name. Then if you run this code, you'll be asked, do you want to install this version on the Harbormaster account? Just type capital Y for yes, and off you go. So that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, follow me on Twitter at @Sharon000. So long.